I just use Google Sheets to make an automation that tracks everything I buy with AI. First, I send the receipt via WhatsApp, Telegram, or email. Then the picture gets picked up from the message and saved into Google Drive, where I can view it anytime. Next, ChatGPT extracts the important infos and saves it neatly into a Google Sheets document here, like the total amount or store name, and many other information, like also the receipt here. Plus, it directly generates you also the analytics for monthly spendings, which payments you're using, which vendors you're using most, in which locations you're buying most, and the receipt dashboard analytics here with graphics. And it even has the FX rates here in case you're using different currencies. And on top of that, I get a reply that includes a clear overview of all key details. And as a bonus, I will address all hater comments for this automation because there's a lot of false information going around. And without further ado, let's get started. Look, I'm not just going here to show you the finished results. Let's do this live. I'm opening up Telegram right now, taking a photo of this receipt here, and click send. Now Telegram received our message and is uploaded first to Google Drive. Then ChatGPT is analyzing this whole invoice and is adding it to our Google Sheets document here. Plus we will receive an answer here. And like you can see, it uploaded this document here. But let's compare if this data is actually correct. So this is the receipt we sent. It's from Happy Balloon. And like you can see, it was correctly extracted here. The total is 63.80. Also this was correctly extracted. And it's Euro. Also this was correctly extracted. And you even have here a receipt link that you can open. And many more here. And the best part is when I click here share, I can share it with anyone with this link, for example my accountant, and he can take over. Now the question, why is this even important? Every lost receipt is a lost tax write-off. By tracking every vendor and every payment, you're literally saving money and hours of manual admin work. And if you're thinking you're not a coder, don't worry. This is 100% no code. And if you can use a web browser like Chrome, you can build this. No prior experience required or complex software. And if you want this automation today, you can find the template in the description box below. That way you can easily import it to your own NNN by clicking here the three dots and click import from file and have it up and running in minutes. Plus I provide a template for the same automation with Gmail and WhatsApp. But for those who want to master the how and customize that for their specific needs, keep your eyes on the screen. I show you exactly how. So if you're ready, open up the instruction in the description box below to follow along. We're going to build this step by step. And stick around because after the build, I'm addressing those hater comments to show you why most people are doing AI automation completely wrong. Alright, when you have the instruction open, first open up NNN. If you don't have an account yet, click get started, otherwise sign in. Once signed in, click create workflow and give it a name like invoice agent. First we want to add a trigger. In this case, let's start with Telegram because it's easy to set up and easy to use. We type in here Telegram and select Telegram. And on trigger, we select on message. Next, we need to provide credentials. For that, we click here and select create new credential. Here, we just need to provide an access token. You open up Telegram and tap on the top right corner, new message, and search for bot father. Everything is written together and make sure that there's a blue check mark. Then you select this one and click start. Then you click on the left button here, open, and select create new bot. Give it a name like my invoice agent and also username like my invoice agent bot and click create bot. Then you receive here the access token and click copy. And then you paste it here and click save. If everything worked fine, you should see connection tested successfully. Alright, let's give this credentials a name like invoice agent, click save and close this. Now you can click execute step. Then you select in your Telegram this invoice agent, click on the username here and then click on message and then click start. Then you see here an output with the text / start, but we don't want it. So we click again, execute step, and this time we take a picture of an invoice and directly send it. This time we receive here a message with multiple photos. If you look here closely, you see we received 4 images, all with different resolutions. The last one has the highest and the biggest file size. We want to use that one. But before we continue, we click here, pin data. This is important so you don't have to do this step again and again. Plus when you go back to the canvas here and click here save and even reload this automation, the last message we tested is still here saved, like you can see. So we received the image but we have only a file ID. Therefore we click here on the plus icon, search for Telegram and select Telegram. And here in the file actions you select get a file. Change your credential to the invoice agent here. And here on the left you go down here and drag and drop the file ID here. And then you click execute step. What happens now is we receive this image. When we click view, we will see the receipt. Let's close this and click save. To recreate this whole automation, next we need to upload this file to Google Drive. For that we click here the plus icon and type Google Drive, select here Google Drive, and select upload file. Here we need to provide our credentials. For that we click here create new credentials, and here we need to provide the client ID and client secret. How to get both I explain in the video in the description box below. It's pretty simple. Here in the file name, we copy and paste the snippet that you provide here, and you paste it here. You leave this here like it is, and under parent folder you select here by URL. Then you open up in the browser the Google Drive folder you want to use and copy this URL here and paste it here. And now you click execute step. When everything works fine, you should see here the check mark. And when you go to your Google Drive, you will see here the file uploaded. Let's go back to Canvas, click here save. The next thing we want to do is to share this file so everybody can access it. You will see later why. For that you click here the plus icon and type again Drive and select here Google Drive. And under file actions, you select share file. Under file, select here by ID, and then drag and drop this ID here. Then under permissions, you click add permission, select under role reader, and under type anyone. Now you click execute step. What you just did is you shared this file. So when I copy and paste this file URL, in the incognito modus, I can still access this file, and it's pretty handy. Then you close this and click save. So after we uploaded our file, we need to analyze it. To do that, we click here the plus icon and search for LLM chain and select basic LLM chain. Under source for prompt, we select define below. Then we go to the instruction and copy and paste this prompt under invoice agent prompt and paste it here. Then you click here add prompt, select here user. Under type, you select image URL. And now important, under this upload file node, you go down here and select WebView content. Do not select WebView link because this one is a direct link and it needs to be this way. Then you can close this node here, and under model you click the plus icon and type in open router and select open router chat model. Here you need to provide credentials. For that you click here create new credential. Then you go to openrouter.ai, create an account here. Under credits add like $5 to $10, and then you click here keys. Create here new API key. Then copy this API key and paste it here and click save. Then you close this. And here you can select any model like OpenAI, GPT-4 Mini. This is actually what I recommend. Or GPT-4, GPT-5, and even like Chinese models, like all AI models that you like. But we are going with GPT-4 1 Mini. Then you close this one, go back to the basic LLM chain and click execute step. Perfect. And when everything worked fine, you should see this. But the problem is, it's like in this text format that's not nicely readable for NLN. So we click here, require specific output format, close this node, and click the plus icon under output parser, and select here, structured output parser. And here we need to provide an example JSON. For that, go to the instructions, and copy this output example format, and then paste it here. When you close this now, and go again in the basic LLM chain, and click execute step, you will receive a structured output here. This enables us to work later easier with this data. For now we close this and click save. Now the last things we have to do is to add this information to Google Sheets and send the reply back to Telegram. Click here the plus icon, search for Sheets, select Google Sheet, and select append row and sheet. Here you have to provide credentials, for that click create new credentials and simply sign in with Google. This you can leave it as it is, and under document you select by URL. Then you go to the instructions and open up the Google Sheets document here. Then click here, file, and make a copy so you have a copy in your own Google Drive. Then you copy this URL, going back to NLN, and paste your URL here. Then you click here on the drop-down menu and select invoices, because it's the sheet here, invoices. And here you need to provide the different values for these columns here. First you want to provide the current date. For that you click here, expression, go to the instructions, and simply copy and paste this little snippet here. For the receipt date, you go to the LLM chain here and drag and drop the date here. For the company name, you select here the company name. For the total, you select here total with tax. For the currency, you select here the currency. And you do the same for all these categories here. And for the receipt link, you go here to Google Drive and select here WebView link. For the month, you click here expression and copy and paste the snippet that you can find on our Sheets month. And paste it here. And the rest of the information you can find here. And these four you leave away since they are calculated in the Google Sheets directly. And when I click now execute step, you will see we will have a new line item here. And it just appeared. Just make sure to drag and drop here so it calculates these values for you correctly. And the last thing we have to do is we need to reply to Telegram. So we click here save first, click here the plus icon, type in Telegram, select here Telegram, and select here send a text message. Make sure to select your right credentials here. Then for chat ID, you go to the Telegram trigger, and under chat, you can find here the chat ID, you drag and drop it here. And for the text, you can click here expression, then click here this little icon, and type something like invoice successfully added. And you can add like information like, for example, the company name. Then you close it, click execute step, and you should now receive the Telegram message. Last thing you have to do is click here save, and now you're finished. When you click here now publish and publish the whole thing, your AI agent is live without clicking execute step. So congrats, you built an invoice automation in under 10 minutes. And now I will address the hater comments and give you a cost breakdown how much it costs to run. Alright, now let's look at the cost. When you go to Open Router and then click here under activity, you will see all runs. And like you can see, the runs here, how much they cost, under cost. So for this automation, a run costs around 0.2 cents. That means when you have 1,000 receipts per month, you're paying $2 for the LLM cost. It's really cheap, especially when you compare it with doing it all manually or hiring a developer. Of course, you also have to pay for your NLN instance, but if you're using NLN already anyway, it's zero. And if you're hosting it by NLN, it costs you around 20 euro per month. And now let's quickly address the hater comments in this viral short about this automation. So a lot of people are screaming about the cost, but we just did the math and it's pretty cheap, like we just saw. Also, a lot of people say, just use your credit card or my bank app already logs that. But here's the problem. A bank notification doesn't count as a valid tax receipt. So if you get an audit, the tax office wants to see the line items, what you actually bought, not just a $50 charge on Amazon. This automation saves the physical receipt as a proof, which is the only way to ensure a 100% safe tax write-off. Then we have developers saying, this is just OCR, I could write this in 10 lines of code. Sure, if you're a developer. But for everyone else, why spend $100 an hour for a dev to write and maintain a script? By using NLN and AI, you are building an AI agent that understands plain English instructions, like you can see here. And if you want to make any changes how it tracks data, you just tell it here. No coding, no maintenance fee, and total control. And lastly, for the privacy concerns regarding WhatsApp, remember, I show you that this works via Telegram or email. If you don't want to use the Meta ecosystem, you don't have to. That's just the beauty of NLN. You own the workflow and you choose where the data flows. So I hope you like this video and see you in the next one.